Good morning, everyone. I'm KJGS Kahagala, third year medical student from the Faculty of Medicine and Allied Sciences, Rajarat University of Sri Lanka. Assessment of microbial colonization in the canteen at Faculty of Medicine and Allied Sciences, Rajarat University of Sri Lanka. Microbial colonization and biofilm formation in food and food handling surfaces lead to food contamination. Consumption of food contaminated may lead to food poisoning and foodborne illnesses. In this study, we assess the microbial colonization and infection control practices in the canteen. Pre-COVID-19 era. This is a descriptive of the Faculty of Medicine and Allied Sciences, both from the kitchen, student dining area, and the retail areas of the canteen. Sterile, moist cotton soaps were used to collect samples, and they were incubated at 35 degrees Celsius for overnight. They were observed for microbial. All soaps which were positive for the microbial growth inoculated into blood and McConkie egg updates separately, and they were incubated overnight at 10% carbon dioxide and room air at 35 degrees Celsius. Subsequent microbial identification was conducted using Cohen and Steele manual. An interviewer administered questionnaire used to assess the infection control practices employed in the canteen. All consenting canteen and cleaning staff was interviewed and the questionnaire was assessed qualitatively. 90 soaps were collected and all of them were positive for the microbial growth after 24 hours of incubation. After gram staining, all gram positive bacilli and gram negative cocci were excluded as environmental commensals. A total of 141 microbes were isolated. 28 gram positive cocci and 13 gram negative bacilli were then proceeded for further identification. 5 methicillin resistant Staphylococcus aureus or MRSA was identified, 1 Escherichia coli organism and 1 Pseudomonas aeruginosa was identified as potential foodborne pathogens. MRSA account for 3.5% of the total isolates. From the 5 MRSA identified, 2 organisms or 40% were identified from kitchen as well as from the dining area respectively. 20% or 1 organism was identified from the retail counter. Escherichia coli accounts for 0.7% of the total isolates and identified from this run dining area. One organism of Pseudomonas aeruginosa was isolated from the kitchen and its sum up was 0.7% of the isolates. All kitchen staff used aprons and chef hats while working, but they did not change them daily. Hand washing was practiced by all staff members before handling food, but prepared food was stored in open environment in room temperature. Cleaning staff cleaned the dining area in the morning and afternoon, the meal times. They used various chemical preparations but lacked proper knowledge to use them effectively. Kitchen dining areas and the retail counters are colonized with potential foodborne pathogens. Therefore, it is important to strengthen the current infection control practices in the canteen. For that, we would like to recommend educating the canteen staff as well as cleaning staff about correct infection control measures and hygienic practices. As well as it is also important to screen the canteen staff and the cleaning staff for MRSA carrier status. Thank you very much.